Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh students. I welcome you in the social class. And this is our fourth lesson which we have seen half in the last video. The temperature zones. Yes. So we have seen about the story, what they are saying, and we have seen about factors affecting climate. Once again, I am saying the definition of climate. Climate is the average condition of weather over a long period of time. Okay. Climate is the average condition of weather over a long period. Now, moving then after this, what we have seen? We have seen here effects of latitude. What the effects of latitude there, and latitude and climatic zones. See, the earth has been divided into three climatic zones. The torrid zone, what does? See, the torrid zone extends from Tropic of Cancer. Here with the help of diagram, it is there. Okay, and we have seen about the temperate zone, that is, these extends from Tropic of Cancer to the Arctic Circle. And then we have seen about the frigid zones, which is coming from Arctic Circle to the North Pole. Okay, we have seen till here, and I hope you have practiced the harvest, students. And we will move forward here to see here other factors affecting climate. Okay, as altitude. What do you mean by altitude, students? First, you understand the concept here. See, the height of an object, or point in relation to sea level or a ground level. You may have noticed that hill stations tend to be much cooler than the plain areas, means at the height. Okay, at the height, high altitude makes the climate moderate. What do you mean by moderate? Mild. Mild. Moderate. 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 Okay, by making it colder. See, as example, you have given that Shivalik Hills of Uttarakhand, Mussoorie, means they are having altitude of 2003 meters above sea level. So, it is significantly cooler than Dehradun because it is having only 640 meters above sea level. So, with the sea, as I said that from the sea level, we will measure that. So, if it is more high than sea level above sea, then it is cool. If it is not, then it may be the hot. Now, coming from sea, distance from the sea, distance, distance, distance from the sea. As the sea takes more time to heat up, and also to cool down, and also sea is taking more time to heat, and also it take more time to cool down. So during summer, land area near the sea heat up faster than the sea. So the area which is near to the sea, it is more heat up more faster than the sea, and the air above the land also heat up and rises. So the force the cool sea breeze to rush, and it cool the land. So what happened here? The forces that cool sea breezes, and it rush and cool the land. So in winter, the land cools down faster than the sea. Here the land cools faster than the sea, and warm breeze from the sea provides warmth to the land. Area near the sea as thus neither very cold nor very warm, because the sea makes the climate moderate. So now coming to the next concept, that is humidity, humidity. Humidity, the amount of moisture in the air is known as humidity. See, area near the equator or hot. Area which is near the equator or hot, so such areas are having a high humidity due to the large amount of water. They get evaporated. So the high humidity results in large amount of rainfall. Through the areas near the equator have climates that are hot and wet and tend to receive heavy rainfall. See, the area which is very near to the equator are very hot due to the humidity, due to the large amount of water, they are getting a chance to be get evaporated. So high humidity results in large amount of rainfall also, and areas near the equator have climate of hot and wet, and it receive heavy rainfall also. Now coming to the wind, W-I-N-D, wind. Wind can be hot or cold, humid or dry. each type of wind affects the climate differently. See, when we are having a type of winds like hot, cold, humid and dry, so it affects the climate in a different way. Like the monsoon winds lowers the temperature, bring rain and humidity to moist part of India. And the desert winds blow in northern India are hot and dry. See, in desert the wind is blowing in a hot way, so that is making climate hot and dry. And the monsoon in India bringing winds are lower, that's why they are bringing temperature, they are bringing rain and humidity is also there in, and it will come in the parts of India and to make the climate hotter and dustier. Okay, so I hope students, here your lesson is finished, you have understood hard words, whatever the underlining hard words are there, please practice that. And thank you, students.